All right, so next topic is we have auto increment. So in SQL, we have, in MySQL especially, we have option called auto increment. What is this auto increment useful? So sometimes in a table, let's say S numbers or student IDs or employee IDs, these values will be automatically incremented. So for example, let me show you simple here. I have a SID. Okay, so S name. So I have a two columns. So sometimes what happens is data will be incremented. Let's say 1, 2, 3, 4. It keep on going like this. And S name we can enter manually, right? So whenever you're inserting the data in the table, we have to specify the SID and also S name. Both values we need to enter into the table. SID as well as S name. And every time we need to specify SID 2, SID 3, 4, 5. For every record, we need to write multiple insert statement. So instead of doing that, whenever I'm creating the table, by default, I will apply one property called as auto increment. So I'll apply auto increment on this particular column. So then what happens is whenever incrementing, whenever inserting the data, S number or some other columns, this value automatically increment and incremented value will be updated inside the table. So we no need to insert these values manually. Okay, we no need to insert these values manually because it is automatically increment. So how we can do that? So this is a simple scenario. There are a lot of scenarios will be there. Some order generation, order also order number also will be generated. So in sequential manner. So let me show you one example. Then you guys can clearly understood when exactly we have to use this. So here I will have one table. Let me create this table. So this is student table. If you have already student, let me just drop the table. So drop table student. Now I'm removing this table. So currently I don't have. So now I'm creating this table, guys. So observe this. And in this particular student table, I have defined S number, S name, and marks. There are three columns I have. So in the first column, S number, this is the primary key column. Means it should not have a duplicates. It should have only unique and not null. And additionally, I also specified auto underscore increment. Auto underscore increment. I'll show you what exactly this keyword will do at the runtime. So additionally, I have added auto increment. So whenever I want to use auto increment, I must specify that column as a primary key. So that's a rule. Whenever you want to use auto underscore increment, you have to use primary key for that particular column. So we cannot use auto increment directly without using primary key. And rest of the columns as usual we have. Now I'm creating this table. So now I have created this table. So now let me insert some data into this particular table. Now you guys should observe this, guys. So how many columns are there in this table? S number, S name, and marks. There are three columns I have. S number, S name, and marks. So S number, I wanted to increment 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, something like that, based upon the number of records. So S number should be incremented by 1 every time. So that I say auto increment here. Now, at the time of inserting the data in the student table, I'm not going to insert a value for S number. I'll insert a value only for S name and marks. Okay. So in that case, we need to specially say what columns you are going to insert. So insert into student, S name and marks. Only these two columns data I'm going to insert. So I'll say S name is X, marks is 60. Now I have inserted this record. Inserted. Now in the second record also, I am saying only S name and marks. Insert this record. And even third record, S name and marks. I'm not specifying anywhere S number. Okay, so I inserted the third record. Now I have inserted three records. After that, now select the data from the table. Select the star from student. So once you get the data from the student, now you guys can observe one thing. S number value is automatically added here. 1, 2, 3 and so on. So who is inserted this 1, 2, 3? Because we say auto increment. Right? So it will automatically increment it by 1, 2, 3. And you can add any number of records here. By default, it will go and add 1, 2, 3, 4, something like that. It keep on adding the values. It will keep on adding the values. So that's the main usage of auto increment. If you have some columns like this, and you no need to enter these values manually because it will go as usual. by incremental mode. And rest of the column values you can specify, and automatically S number column will be incremented. Okay, this is the use of auto increment. If you want to add more number of columns also, suppose I'm removing one record here. Let's say delete from student where S number is equal to, I'll say 2. S number is equal to 2 record I'm removing. So I'm deleting this. So record is deleted. Now select star from student. So currently 2 is deleted. I have only 1 and 3. Now I'm executing this record. Observe guys, I'm executing this record now. I'm inserting this record. I'm not specifying any S number. I'm inserting this record. So second record is already deleted. Okay. Now inserting this record once again. So new record is inserted. Now again select star from student. Now it is saying it is added a new record with the 4 number. So 2 is not added. 2 record is already deleted earlier. So it will not repeat the same number. Every time whenever you are adding the new record, it will give the new number here. Every time it will generate the next number. Whatever numbers are there, 1, 3 is already there. What is the next number? 4. But it will not create 2 here because 2 is already created earlier, and also we removed it. We already used it. So it will not consider the user numbers. It will always create the new number. Okay. So 1, 3, 4 is there. So for example, I'll remove the third record now. So delete student where S number is equal to 3. So third record is deleted. Now when I execute this record, now we have only 1, 4. 2 is gone, 3 is also gone. Now I'll execute this record. I'll insert this record one more time. So insert it. Now execute the select star from, then fifth record is added. So 3, 2 is gone. So the next, and after 4, the next number is 5. So 5 is added. So this is how we need to do auto increment. Okay. So if there are any columns like this, if you want to increment in sequential manner, we can specify the auto increment. And one more thing is we can also specify the starting value of auto increment. So by default, if I say auto increment, it is starting from 1, 2, 3, 4, right? So we can specify the starting value of the auto increment also. In that case, we need to alter the table. So previously I say only auto increment here. By default, the behavior is it will start from 1, increment by 1 every time. But when I say alter student auto increment underscore 100, so I'm just altering the table with this column auto increment. I make it as 100 now. So then what I will do is I'll just delete all the stuff from student table for now. So delete from student. I'll insert all the records one more time. Okay, delete to start from student. Whenever deleting, you don't require star. So just delete from student. So every record is deleted. Okay, so it's not deleted. So before deleting deleting the records or updating the records, execute this command. So SQL save updates, and then we can delete the record from the table. So execute this, make it 0, so SQL save 0, and delete the record from the student. So now it is deleted. So now when I see select star from student, we don't have any records. So completely empty records, right? Now I'll start freshly now one more time. So this time I created this table with auto increment, and here I alter the table. I specify auto increment as 100 now. Now observe this, what happens. So again, I'm inserting the fresh records. Okay, I'm inserting the fresh records. And before that, drop the table once again and create this table once again. Right, so now I set alter table. And now inserting 3 records. Now I'm inserting 3 records one after another. Now inserted. So once I have inserted, now we can go and select the table. So where is select statement? Here it is. Select star from student. So now we can see it is started from 100. So this is the starting value, guys. So alter table student auto increment is equal to 100. So initially by default, it will start from 1, increment by 1 every time. So if you want to specify the starting value, you can also specify like this. 100 is starting value. So 101, 102, it will go on like this. So this is how we need to use auto increment option in MySQL. So this is not a constraint. Okay, this is not a constraint. This is another class we have to specify the incremented columns. Okay. So this is all about auto increment. So the next topic is limit keyword. So we have also limit class in MySQL. So what is use of limit? So it is very simple, guys. So sometimes whenever you are retrieving the data from the table, by default you will get all the data, right? So for example, let me just use HR database, and inside this we have an employees table, right? So let me just let's say select the star from employees. So when I execute this query, you will get all the data by default. So here, if you see, there are so many records are there, n number of rows are there, and I want to display some rows, few room. I want to limit the number of records. Here there are so many records are displayed, but I don't want to see all the records. I want to see only first 10 records in a table. So in MySQL, Workbench is given default option like this. So here you can, in the drop down box, we can select how many rows you want to display. So if you select limit to 10 rows and then execute this command, you will get only 10 rows. Okay, this is the default option which is given by the MySQL. But instead of using this option, through query also we can do that. And we can do that by using limit keyword. So here I'll say select star from employees, I'll say limit and 10. I want to print only 5 records, let's say 5 here. So limit keyword will be used like this. So when I execute this query, it will give you only 5 records. So limit keyword will be retrieving the rows, specific rows, limited rows basically. Okay, so that's simple use of limit keyword. So limit is used to display limited rows from the table. And how to use it? Select star from the table name, limit 10. And sometimes we can also get the record from one range to another range. Suppose I have more records here. When I say only select star from employees, I want to display the record from 5th to 10th, 5th row to 10th row. And I don't want to display 1 to 5 records. I want to display from 5th row to 10th row. Then you can also specify the range, 5 comma 10. So now it will start from 5th row and display till 10th row. Now we can execute this. It will give you 5 different rows, but it will start from the 5th row. This is actually 5th row. Okay, when I execute this query, the first row is 100. So 105 is the 5th row. It is started here. And what is the 10th row here? 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 10th row is 110. So when I execute this, it will give you from 105 to. So it's calculated 10 rows, guys. It will start from the 5th row. From the 5th row, it will count 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. It is not exactly row number. It is counting the 10 rows. From the 5th row, it will count 10 more rows. So 5 to 10, I have printed here. So this is how we can also use limit keyword. So this is simple. And the next topic we are going to discuss about views and indexes. So this is all about views, limit keyword, guys. Auto increment and then limit keyword.